Hey folks, Dagan here from PMTVUK, and today I'm here to talk about one of the most iconic brands to come out of the United States, used by countless chart-topping artists of all styles and genres, from Eric Clapton to Joe Walsh, Billy Joe Armstrong to Bryan Adams. Today I'm talking about Guild guitars, and they're now available at PMT. I have three wonderful Guild acoustics to show you later on in this video, so stick around for that, some specs and some sounds. But first, let's get into some Guild history. The Guild Guitar Company was founded in 1952, and their guitars started to hit the shelves in 1953. It was started in New York by guitarist and music store owner Alfred Dronge and George Mann, who just so happened to be the ex-vice president of a certain Epiphone guitar company. Now that's quite a pairing to start a guitar company. They must have known they were onto something. I mean, they're still here to this day, so they certainly succeeded. Still ticking all the boxes too, whether you're playing old school New York jazz on it, which would have been one of the first things to ever be played on a Guild guitar, all the way through to modern rock and indie, Guild guitars have helped create some of the greatest music in history. The name evokes quality and such an amazing artist roster. Musicians such as Brian May, Stevie Ray Vaughan, Billy Duffy and Tom Petty, amongst many other household names, all swear by their Guild acoustic. Speaking of being historic, Guild were part of a big landmark in music history. In the mid-60s, there was a new generation of folk rockers up and coming, and they were drawn to the look, sound and style of a Guild guitar. And it was Mr. Richie Haves who opened Woodstock Festival with his Guild D40 in 1969. They helped innovate the guitar too. In 1972, they were the first brand to manufacture a Dreadnought guitar with a cutaway, the D40C. So this obviously allowed much better access to the higher frets, and it's a feature which is copied by almost every other guitar brand to this day. I'll talk about these in a second, but right now, let's talk about this beautiful thing I have in my hand. This is the Guild F250 CE Deluxe. This is a stunning guitar. As you can see, it's a jumbo body shape, but flamed maple back and sides. So that gives it a lovely robust low end thanks to the size, but a nice crisp high end thanks to that flamed maple. It also features a solid spruce top, which again just adds to the warmth, especially when paired with the pokey maple back and sides. Also makes it project like nothing else. It's utterly amazing. Speaking of being amazing, look at it, it's fantastic. Beautiful shiny gloss mirror finish with white binding, setting it off all the way up the mahogany neck too. Up top you have the iconic Guild Peak headstock with a mother of pearl abalone logo, open gear tuners on the back, which are fantastic. Pow Ferro fingerboard, 20 frets, the whole thing is 25.5-inch scale, and as you can tell, this is an electro-acoustic guitar, so it features Guild's AP1 preamp system and a pickup under the bridge. And I believe that's all the specs. Let's hear it some more. Such a fantastic guitar. Thank you. This is the incredible Guild D260CE Deluxe. It's a dreadnought body shape, so in my opinion, the Swiss Army body shape. The jumbo stuff is fantastic for chord work, but this is great for chord work, but also finger picking stuff. Sometimes that can get lost in jumbo guitars. You can do strumming, you can do finger picking, you can do chicken picking, anything with a dreadnought guitar. And like I said at the start, Guild were the first to put a cutaway in it. Spec wise on this Guild D260CE Deluxe, solid spruce top as you'd expect, but on the back and sides, you're looking at striped ebony. This tone wood doesn't only look fantastic, it also has a very unique snap to it. It's kind of like maple, but a bit more in the mid-range. It's a fantastic sounding instrument, and hopefully this is coming across okay on YouTube. If not, you've got to get yourself to a PMT store and try one of these out for yourself. Aesthetically, it's set off amazing with some white binding all the way up the mahogany neck, that Guild peak headstock as well with the open gear tuners, which is a staple on these deluxe models. It features a Powferro fingerboard, 20 frets. The whole thing is 25.5-inch scale, and it is electronic, as you can see. It has Guild's AP1 pickup and preamp system in it, with the volume and tone controls just inside the beautiful abalone sound hole right there. Now, I think that's all the specs on the Guild D260CE Deluxe. Let's hear it some more, shall we? Again, because it's cutaway, you can get to the dusty end, no problem at all. Now, to have a cutaway on an acoustic guitar, innovative as it may be, isn't for everyone. Some people do think that it sucks a bit of the tone and a bit of the life out of the guitar. So if you're looking at this thinking, that'd be great if it didn't have a cutaway, there's this guy. This is the Guild D260E, not CE, just electric, Deluxe. So this is what you'd call a standard D260E Deluxe, because there's no cutaway. It's a classic dreadnought. The same specs as this beautiful beast though. Solid spruce top, striped ebony back and sides, all set off with amazing white binding. This thing looks as good as it sounds, and damn, it sounds good, especially in person. The whole thing resonates just beautifully. It's quite a peculiar mix, ebony and Sitka spruce, but it's working for me, and hopefully it's working for you guys out there as well. Mahogany neck, 25.5-inch scale, Powferro fingerboard with 20 frets, the peak headstock, the open gear tuners, the Guild AP1 preamp system, it just hasn't got the cutaway. Does that give you a different sound? I'm not too sure. Please comment down below what you think. You guys are probably wanting a bit more chord work than solo stuff, but these are set up so good from the factory. The action is incredible. all the way up the neck as well, and for the price point, it's something to behold. An iconic brand with an iconic feel and an iconic sound for not a lot of money, available at PMT. So there we have it, ladies and gents, some history of the iconic Guild brand, as well as three beautiful acoustic numbers. There's lots of guitars available from Guild, though these are just three that I really enjoyed the feel of, and I wanted to show you the differences between cutaway and a non-cutaway Guild guitar. Get your fine self over to pmtonline.co.uk and check out the entire Guild range. But for now, if you enjoy that, give this video a like and subscribe to PMTVUK for lots more cool guitar and music-related content. Please comment down below your favourite Guild player, your favourite Guild guitar, or even just a cool Guild memory you've got. For me, I think the first time I ever saw Guild was, I got to see Queen when I was a kid, and Love of My Life was played on a Guild 12 string. And ever since then, I was like, Guild is amazing. If you want any more information on Guild guitars, get yourself over to pmtonline.co.uk. Like I said before, we are PMT House of Rock on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook. Give us a like and a follow to see pictures of these Guilds with nice filters on. I've been Dagan, and I'll see you next time.